this program started, students wanted us to at least put the packs in a plastic bag so that others cannot see that they have requested for food. But okay. Now it is just that I'm hungry, I don't care what anyone says, I'll just take this food. This actually, they have tasted it, it is actually very good.
Everyone is crying.
Around 500 students on each campus, actually. Over, I think 2,000 overall.
Okay.
Everyone is crying out for peace, yeah.
When students go to class hungry, that impacts on their studies. And it impacting on their studies, they are unable to produce the results that we require as a university. And that automatically means that the economy of the country is going to be affected. We've got NFSAS, which provides funding to us for academic, for tuitions, and also for textbooks and whatnot. If we get students who are on that program of NFSAS failing, it means that the government has to keep on sponsoring the very same people, and as a result, the taxes, all those things are going to be very high. So I can appeal to donors to put more funds on Stop Hunger so that we do not see a great lot of people who've got academic potential failing because of just lack of food.
How often do you receive the meal packs?
We usually receive the meal packs, it's twice per week.
And what do the meals taste like?
Yeah, it's good, especially you know after I cook the sergeant. Yeah, we put it together, that's where it gets tasty. Sometimes I used to come to school without food, and I would be really hungry, And then hoping that maybe when I get home, I would have something to eat. But unfortunately, sometimes when I get home, I do not really you know find enough food for me to eat. Last year I was doing my first year, and I actually failed English, which was English 1A. But then this year I you know, qualified.
You better give it up.
Does it make it easier to concentrate?
Yes, it does. It has rather to make me to concentrate. And because before, like, maybe you're trying to study, but you're thinking, oh, when I get home, what am I going to eat and stuff? So it becomes stressful sometimes. But knowing that at least I have something to cook when I go home, so I study more relaxed and knowing that there's something that I'll eat when I get back home. So yeah, it has helped me to concentrate a lot in my studies, and I am improving, and I'm thankful for that.
But tell me, how far is it from the bottom?
You know, the first time I received this food, the thing what happened to me, I was amazed. How come these people are providing for people whom they've been met before? And this is tremendous, this is nice. And I was like, this is beyond words, you know. And I was like, okay, since they've planted in me, I'm gonna try by all means that next time I'm gonna plant to them, to those who don't have means.
Since Stop Hunger and NASA meals have been supplied to your students, have you seen a difference?
A great difference, actually. The letters that I've given you from students are certainly we have seen students coming to us thanking us on the meal packs that they do receive from us. We have also got other departments coming to us, academic departments, telling us about the improvement of students in terms of academics because of the intervention of Stop Hunger meal packs. student went to the clinic who complained about stomach cramps, and when they went, when they went into details trying to ascertain what could be the problem of the student, she eventually opened up to them to say, look, I have went for 3 days without eating. And they found out that that was actually the cause of her getting stomach cramps. And they contacted me at Soweto campus to say, Logic, we've got this kind of student. And then we gave them packs. After that, she never came back to the clinic.